The Ministry of Secondary Education has developed a distance learning platform for students of secondary education in Cameroon. A series of lessons taught by qualified teachers for secondary school students. Under the stewardship of Professor Pauline Nalovalyonga in collaboration with the Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications, CAMTEL, CRTV, and UNESCO, we are introducing distance learning as another teaching and learning method which is different from the traditional classroom setting that you are all used to. In the distance education mode, you are not with the teacher in person, so take your time, relax, listen to the teacher, take down notes and visit the following links for any questions or answers to your questions. Take it in your stride. This is Cameroon's solution to COVID-19 and beyond. Professor Nalovalyonga, Minister of Secondary Education.
Welcome to this learning session. I am D. John Stanley, your mathematics teacher. Let's begin this lesson by correcting the assignment we had in the last lesson. The first question is for us to find the value of x for which the matrix 1, negative 2, x, 4 has no inverse. Now, for a matrix not to have an inverse, it means the determinant of that matrix is zero. That's the kind of matrix we call singular matrix. So this matrix 1, negative 2, x, 4 has no inverse means that the determinant of that matrix is equal to zero. To calculate the determinant, we said that we find the products of the elements in the leading diagonal. So we'll have 1 times 4, which gives us 4, minus, we now multiply the elements in the other diagonal. So we have x times negative 2, it will give us negative 2x. That should be equal to 0. This is a linear equation, and to solve it, we will have, when we open the bracket, we have 4 plus 2x is equal to 0. So 2x is equal to negative 4. We now divide both sides by 2. So x is equal to negative 2. So that's the value of x for which that matrix has no inverse. That's it you see on the screen. For the second question, find the matrix y. Given that y times the matrix negative 2, 0, 3, 1 is equal to the identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. Now, we said that if you multiply two matrices and the result is an identity matrix, then it means one of the matrix is the inverse of the other. So this is the idea. The concept is that a matrix M times M inverse gives us the identity matrix. The equation that is giving us, we have the matrix Y times this other matrix, negative 2, 0, 3, 1. And the result is the identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. Which means that this matrix Y is like our M here, and this matrix here is like our M inverse. What does that signify? What does that mean? It means that the inverse, if we want to get Y, we should simply get the inverse of this matrix. The inverse of this matrix is going to be our Y. And when we multiply the Y and its inverse, it will give us the identity matrix. So let's do that. The inverse of this matrix. So let's say, this matrix be equal to M negative 2, 0, 3, 1. It means that the determinant of M is equal to negative 2 times 1, that's the product here, minus 3 times 0, which is 0. So the inverse is, the determinant is negative 2. Now that we have the determinant, what about the adjoint? Adjoint M will be the matrix. We swap the elements in the main diagonal. So 1 comes here and negative 2 is here. This one, we maintain their position, but we change the signs. 0 will be 0 and 3 will be negative 3. So M inverse is equal to, M inverse is calculated as 1 divided by the determinant, which was negative 2, into this adjoint, which is 1, 0, negative 3, negative 2. We can leave it like this, or we can multiply inside. If we multiply inside, we'll have negative half, that's multiplying each entry by negative half. Then 0, 3 over 2, 2, this one will be 1. So that will be our M inverse. Now this M inverse is going to be Y. So effectively, this is the matrix Y that we are looking for. If we take this matrix and multiply by this one, it will give us the identity matrix. So there we found Y is the inverse of this matrix, like we said, and then Y is 1 all over the determinants of that matrix, which is negative half, negative 2, times the adjoint, and it gives us this matrix, which is the very matrix that we have just obtained. I decided to do a verification just to take the matrix that we have just calculated, that we have just obtained, and then multiply it by this one. And when we take this matrix and multiply with this, it actually gives us 1, 0, 0, 1, which means that this matrix is correct. We've calculated well. Okay, let's move on. The third question, given that A is equal to that matrix, matrix A is this one, and we are also told that adjoint A is this. So find R and S. What happens here is that we will look for the adjoints of this matrix given us. And since they say that that adjoint is the same as this, then we'll equate the two and solve for R. So let's do that. A is given as 2 minus R, 2R minus 1. Then we have 6. Negative 3 S plus 2. This is the matrix A. If we were looking for the adjoint here, adjoint A will be the matrix that is obtained by swapping this element in the main diagonal. So we will have S plus 2 here, and then 2R minus 1 here. These entries, we change their signs. We have negative 6 and then 3. But in the question, we are told that adjoint A is also given as, adjoint A is given as 3, negative 6, 3, negative 1. That's the adjoint that is given, which means this is the same as this. So if that's the case, we have S plus 2, 3, negative 6, 2R minus 1 is equal to 3, negative 6, 3, negative 1. This element here is the same as this. This element is the same as this. In fact, when we have two matrices that are equal, then their corresponding elements are also equal. So S plus 2 is equal to 3. And that gives us s as 3 minus 2, which is 1. Also, 2r minus 1 will be equal to negative 1, which means 2r is equal to 0. Because when you add 1 to both sides, this one will disappear and then you have 0. So r is equal to 0 divided by 2, which gives us 0. So those are the values of r and s. And that's it. We have it there. So we started by looking for the adjoint. Then we equated the two adjoints. That's the adjoint of A plus the one that was given. And then we solved the two linear equations that result from there. And when we do that, we obtain S as 1 and R as 0. Now, having done the correction of the assignment, we want to move on. And let me remind you of the fact that we are still looking at numbers and operations in the sets of numbers. That's the module we've been looking at for the past two lessons. We've already done estimation. Estimations, we've done approximation and errors, we've done indices, sets and logarithms. We've started matrices. In the last two lessons, we were looking at matrices. And we will continue still in matrices to look at the next lesson, which is matrix equation. Now, the lesson matrix equation is actually a portion of the first part of solving simultaneous linear equations. That's to say that we'll see how we can solve simultaneous linear equations using matrix or using matrices. This first part, we will see how we can generate the matrix equation. This is the plan that we will be using. We'll get to the objectives of the lesson. We'll look at the prerequisites, a real life situation, learning activity. We'll go to exercises of application or application exercises, and then we'll end with an assignment. The objectives of the lesson are that by the end of this lesson, the learner should be able to form matrix equation from a system of two linear simultaneous equations. Secondly, the learner should be able to identify cases where there is no solution or unique solution. But before we get into the lesson proper, what is that concept that is very important for you to have mastered so that the lesson can move on smoothly? The learner should be able to find the inverse of any 2x2 matrix, if at all the inverse exists. So let's verify that with these questions. The first question is for us to find the inverse of A, where A is equal to 5, 5, 14, or 15. That's the matrix. And then secondly, we will do the products, A times A inverse, and then state the property that has been verified by that. Let's go together and look at that. Now, the inverse of a matrix is calculated as 1 divided by the determinant times the adjoint of that matrix. So if we look at the adjoint or the inverse of A, it will be 1 divided by its determinant. And the determinant of A is 5 times 15 minus 5 times 14, all into the adjoint. The adjoint is obtained by swapping the elements of this element, the position of the elements in the main diagonal. So 15 goes up, 5 goes down. Then 14 and 5 of the other diagonal, we simply change their signs. When we simplify this, we have 1 all over 75 minus 70, which is 1 all over 5, into this adjoint. And so A inverse is, when we multiply each entry by 1 fifth, we have 3, negative 1, negative 14 over 5, 1. So that's adjoint, the inverse of A. Now, the next thing is for us to find the product A inverse. So we take the matrix A times the inverse, which is this. Now, we can remove, we can, multiplication is associative, which means that multiplying these three or this matrix by this scalar and this matrix, we can take this 1 over 5 and put it in front and then multiply the two matrices first. When we do that, we'll have 1 all over 5 into this. That's 75 minus 70, which is obtained by 5 times 15 plus 5 times negative 14, which is negative 70. If we do like that for all of them, we'll have the final answer will be 1001. And the property that this verifies is that when you multiply a matrix by its inverse, it gives you the identity matrix. Question 2. Find the inverse of M, where M is equal to 2, 8, negative 4, negative 16. Let's do that together. M is equal to 2, 8, negative 4, negative 16. To get the inverse of this matrix, we say the determinant of M is equal to negative 16 times 2 minus negative 4 times 8. When we find this product, it gives us negative 32 minus this product is negative 32. So we end up with negative 32 plus 32, and that is 0, which means the determinant of M is 0. And we said earlier, and even in the last lesson, we said that when a matrix has a determinant of 0, it means that matrix does not have an inverse. So in this case, there is no inverse for M. M is non-invertible. So that's it. M does not have an inverse since the determinant is 0. So we end there. Let's look at this problem, a real life situation. A Form 4 student told his math teacher that a week ago he bought 2 pens, we will represent abbreviated pens with P, and 1 pencil, which is abbreviated C, for 500 francs CFA. He added that because the items were cheap, he decided to buy more. And this time he bought 6 pens and 3 pencils for 1,200 francs CFA. Now, based on this student's statements, is this situation realistic? Just reflect on it and attempt to see whether you can figure out the response to that. If you can do it, good and fine, but if not, don't bother. Towards the end of the lesson, we'll see how we can resolve that. Let's get now into the learning activity. Given that the product of those two matrices, these two matrices gives us this matrix 1, negative 4. Carry out the multiplication on the left-hand side. From the equality of the two matrices, this is equal to this, write two equations. With step 3, from the results in step 1 and 2, what can we conclude? 4. Transform the equations below into a matrix equation of the form Mn. Mx is equal to n. So this is the matrix. These are the two simultaneous equations for us to transform into a matrix equation. Find the inverse of M, where M is equal to 2, 1, negative 1, 3. If M inverse does not exist, what does that suggest about the pair of equations? Let's get the solutions now. The first is for us to multiply these two matrices on the left. To multiply, we take the first row, it dives down, multiply these two elements here. So we have 1 times x plus 1 times y, and that will give us x plus y. And then in the second case, we'll have 2x minus y. So we have this matrix is equal to this. From the equality of two matrices, this is equal to this. Write two equations. Now we know that when two matrices are equal, it means corresponding elements are equal. The first element is x plus y, so it would be equal to 1, while 2x minus y is equal to negative 4. So these are the two equations. So from the results in step 1 and 2, what can we conclude? We can conclude that when we multiply two matrices, like what we had here, when we multiply two matrices, it can end up resulting into two equations, two simultaneous equations. So the conclusion is that from a matrix equation, we can get a pair of simultaneous equations. Now, we are expected to transform these simultaneous equations into a matrix equation. So this is technically the reverse of what we have just done. We had a matrix equation, we multiply and obtain two simultaneous equations. Now we have two simultaneous equations which we want to transform into a matrix equation of the form M times X is equal to N. Now let's analyze it. They say M will be the matrix of the coefficients of X and Y. The coefficient of X here is 2, the coefficient of Y is 1. So in that matrix, matrix M will have the first row will be 2, 1. The second row will be coefficients of X here is negative 1 and coefficients of Y here is 3. So the second row will be negative 1, 3. And then the matrix X is the column matrix of the unknowns. The unknowns in these two equations are X and Y. So we'll have times XY. And then the last matrix will constitute these two constants. So this is the matrix equation we have generated. Find the inverse of M, where M is this. Now M is this matrix that we have here. So we are expected to find the inverse. The inverse will be 1 divided by the determinant, which is 2 times 3 is 6, minus negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Into the adjoint, we've swapped the elements in the main diagonal, and then we've changed the sign of entries in the other diagonal. When we simplify this, we have 1 all over 7 into this matrix, which gives us this. If M inverse does not exist, what does that suggest about the pair of equations? If M inverse does not exist, it means that the matrix of coefficients of X and Y, that matrix is having a determinant of 0. And in that case, it means that the equations cannot be solved. So the equation has no, the system of equations has no unique solution. What can we summarize from this lesson? When given two simultaneous equations like this, we can form a matrix equation by getting the coefficients of X and Y into one matrix, the unknowns into another matrix, which is a column matrix, and the constant into another column matrix. Secondly, we've also seen that if the determinant of the matrix of the coefficients is equal to 0, it means that matrix has no unique solution, or it has an infinite set of solutions. Let's look at this application exercise, which will permit you to master much properly what we have been looking at. Now, the first question is for us to form a matrix equation for these two sets of simultaneous equations. The first one is x plus 2y is equal to 15 and x plus 3y is equal to 19. Okay, so we have x plus 2y is equal to 15. Then we have x plus 3y is equal to 19. We are expected to form a matrix equation of the form mx is equal to n. So the matrix equation we'll have our m, which constitutes the coefficients of x and y for the two equations. The coefficient of x here is 1, the coefficient of y here is 2, of x here is 1, and of y here is 3. Next is the matrix x, which is made up of the unknowns. So we have x and y here. And then finally, 15, 19. That is the matrix equation we have just formed. So that's it there. We have the matrix equation here. Now, we were also expected to find the inverse, M inverse, or the inverse of M. This is our M. The main matrix here is M. So, we say that M is equal to 1, 2, 1, 3. The inverse of M is calculated first. We get the determinant of M, which is 3 times 1, which is 3, minus 1 times 2, which is 2, and that gives us 1. We also look for the adjoint of M, which gives us 3 comes here, 1 goes there, then 2 becomes negative 2, 1 becomes negative 1. So M inverse is equal to 1 divided by the determinant, which is 1, into 3, negative 2, negative 1, 1. So the inverse is just 3, negative 2, negative 1, 1. Why? Because 1 divided by 1 is 1, and when we multiply each entry by 1, it remains the same. So that's it. The determinant is 1, and when we take that 1, we get the adjoint. Inverse is 1 divided by 1 times the adjoint, and we have that. In the next case, we are to solve this. We are to form the matrix equation here. So you see our main matrix M is equal to 3, 8, coefficient here of U here is 1, and of V here is negative 1, into U, V is equal to this column matrix with negative 2 and negative 6 as the entries. M is this matrix, so determinant of M we solve to have negative 11. To find M inverse, we find first the adjoint, we've obtained the adjoint is here, and so M inverse is 1 all over negative 11 times the adjoint. So that it gives us that. And the next question is for us to solve. Without solving the system of equations, show using a concept in matrices that the following equations have no unique solution. For it to have no unique solution, we said the inverse of the matrix of coefficients should not exist. So when we take like this equation, we form our matrix equation, we have this. The determinant of this matrix is equal to 2 times 5 minus 5 times 2, which is 10 minus 10, and that gives us 0. Just the fact that the determinant is 0 automatically means that this matrix does not have an inverse. And when it doesn't have an inverse, it means there are no unique solutions. The same argument will come here. We form the matrix equation, and now the determinant of this matrix is equal to 7 minus 7. Observe that 7 times 1 is 7, minus 1 times 7 is 7, so it gives us 0. Again, since the determinant is 0, it has no unique solution. For what value of k will the pair of linear simultaneous equations thus have no unique solution? As we have just said, if it has no unique solution, then it means the matrix of the coefficients should have no inverse. The determinant should be 0. So the first thing is to form the matrix equation, which is this. For no unique solution, the determinant of this matrix, which is obtained from here, should be 0. So the determinant is 12 times 3 minus k times 4, which is 4k, and it's equal to 0. When we solve for k, we will have 9. To end up, let's look at the real life situation we had earlier. We said the students bought 2 pens and 1 pencil for 500 francs. And then also, let me put the equations on the board. So we have 2x, 2p plus c was 500. And then he also bought 6 pens plus 3 pencils for 1,200. In the question we had earlier, it was 1,200. So we are expected to verify whether it was a realistic situation. So when we form the matrix equation, we'll have 2,163. The unknowns are P and C, is equal to 500 and 1,200. So this 7 here is not supposed to be 7, it's supposed to be 1,200. Now, the main matrix now, our matrix here is, we consider it to be A, and the determinant is 2 times 3 minus 6 times 1, and that the answer will be 0. And since the determinant of A is equal to 0, it means that the inverse of A does not exist. And since it doesn't have an inverse, it means that what the student presented was unrealistic. Here is the assignment that you will do later on to reinforce what you have learned in this lesson. When we meet in the next lesson, we will be looking at solving simultaneous linear equations using matrix method or using matrices. So this is the end of our lesson. Ona tege minga matege nyum, ona tege majang matege ndom, mane tambia ninyane njubyayen, ngani bana matege mot, ngani lakiri watege ndong, esa kina bia dinkido, mane tambia ninyane njubyayen, tam tama mote tam zabike, tam tama tonge tam zabike, tam tam tama mote tam zabike. Mane tambia ninyane njubyayen.